A very good afternoon all. I'm Amreen Mughal. You might have noticed a few highlighted words in my presentation title. Yes, I want your attention on those. My aim is to convey a message that it is too early to consider apelin as a savior for the galaxy of vascular diseases. Vascular diseases, which are the complications arised from damaged blood vessels. We commonly know them with the words like hypertension or heart failure. You know, they are the leading cause of the death worldwide. We all have real close ones, loved ones who are suffering from vascular diseases. It's a sad reality, right? So the first question comes in our mind, why? Don't we have medicines? Yes, we do. But these diseases are so complex that we are still far away from understanding them. Another reason for this increased disease toll is the side effects, which are the unwanted effect when healthy tissue is exposed to the medicine. So here come my research into picture. I'm working with a peptide known as apelin, which is secreted from fat cells. So more amount of fat, more amount of apelin. It should be good, right? Indeed, scientists are thinking like that. They are thinking more amount of apelin is good for treating vascular diseases, and they are trying to make apelin as a medicine. But wait, does it hold true for every vascular disease or for every part of our body? We don't know yet. We don't know all the vascular effects of apelin in normal physiology, forget about patients. So in my research, I'm trying to determine vascular effects of apelin using two blood vessels. Cerebral arteries, which supply blood to the brain, and coronary arteries, which supply blood to the heart to make it happy. And I found out apelin does not behave same in these two blood vessels. Yes, apelin does not behave same in these two blood vessels, which means apelin, by dilating coronary arteries, increases blood supply to heart to make it happy, which is good, right? But at the same time, apelin, by contracting cerebral arteries, decreases blood supply to the brain to make it unhappy. So for now, can we ignore brain? No, we cannot. Brain is so, so important to us. It regulates every part of our body, including heart. So my research suggests that when we give apelin to treat vascular diseases in heart, we might be increasing chances of vascular diseases in brain. My research also provides novel directions which can be utilized to design safe apelin-based therapy with higher beneficial effects and lesser side effects. So the take-home message is, we should not forget that our heart and brain cannot live without each other, and we should respect that while designing apelin-based therapy. Thank you.